Morocco has turned its head to promote the resources of our kingdom. Our government is progressively implementing all the means that could enable people to have clean energy and an affordable price. I think that renewable energies are one of the best examples you can provide to show that mechanical engineering can be applied everywhere. I'm a mechanical engineering graduate student, and I've been studying for 3 years now at NSEM Engineering School. Basically, I'm skilled in the conception of machines. This is what I will perform at work, advancing people, humanity with technologies and mechanics. There is an Arabic adage that tells you to not fish for someone, but to teach him how to take on the fish. I believe that if you build an irrigation system that would actually make crops grow, it would be better than actually give people food. And this, I believe that mechanical engineering would do it anywhere. Mechanical engineering could be applied in any field.
Being an engineer is like solving problems every day. So we are here to provide solutions to problems, and I try on a day-to-day basis to find some elegant solution. ADERE is a public institution whose aim is to promote renewable energy and energy efficiency in the country, because we found out on the Moroccan level that we need a very good agency, national agency, in terms of renewable energy and energy efficiency, because we're very dependent of petroleum imports. And that's why renewable energy and energy efficiency have been set up as a priority on the highest level of the country.
The Kingdom of Morocco is undergoing a renewable energy revolution. Under mandates from the king and government, the country is positioning itself to become a regional leader in the large-scale rollout of clean energy technologies. Morocco will break away from its current and debilitating reliance on imports for over 94% of its energy supply. By 2020, 42% of the kingdom's power production will come from its own domestic sources of renewable energy.
As they say, for the game to begin, someone needs to kick the ball first. So Morocco and Massin has kicked the ball and the game has started. A clear commitment by His Highness the King of Morocco was basically the first starter of the game. This started with a very interesting vision of procuring, starting with 500 megawatts of solar energy and procuring this by 2015. This would be a precedent for the North African region, with Morocco taking the flag in promoting renewables in North Africa.
We as DESERTEC Foundation, we are following the discussion in Morocco for a long time. DESERTEC is a global concept. It basically describes a vision how energy security can lead to climate security, and activities like in Morocco and in many other countries are one piece of a puzzle. So I think Morocco can be an example for the rest of the world, being a pioneer in renewable energy.
Morocco is attracting a lot of interest because it's one of the most stable countries in the region. With the Arab Spring, you know, it's been less affected. The economy continues to grow very well here, and even better than some of the southern European countries.
As Morocco's economy grows, so too does its appetite for energy. The kingdom's citizens need power solutions that can meet this growing demand and allow them to enjoy newfound prosperity. Moroccan energy plans for wind, solar, hydro, and biomass will not only drive the modernization of the economy and improve its energy independence, but also improve its citizens' quality of life. Solutions are being implemented across the country to move the kingdom onto a clean and prosperous path. Among them is the launch of an ambitious series of solar power plants in the Moroccan deserts of Ouazzazate.
Je rappelle, par rapport aux objectifs du plan solaire, nous avions fait le choix de focaliser sur un premier projet, en l'occurrence Ouazzazate, avec une première phase qui peut aller jusqu'à 160 MW, c'est-à-dire 500 MW pour fin 2015, avec un premier 160 MW en 2014. L'idée était de d'optimiser la valeur ajoutée générée par ces projets. Et dans ce sens-là, déjà dans le cadre de Warzazat, donc des actions concrètes visant à avoir des retombées positives sur le territoire de Warzazat et les habitants de la région.
If in 5 to 10 years we are considered as experts in matters of renewable energy and energy efficiency, I think we gained our prize. We are also there to train the engineers that want to actually be reconverted to the renewable energy and energy efficiency side, because what is it to promote a law on how to build best, and then not to have the skilled builders and workers.
Since technology can't be from just one country, you often find yourself as an engineer working on projects that previous other international teams have been working on. I want to see such projects with Moroccans within the teams, not only foreign people. Not only would it improve the employment rate of people, but also such people would be lucky to have this experience and maybe actually take it to another city and even another country that is in need more than Morocco.
Morocco's clean power will also be needed to expand irrigation systems and desalinate water for use in the country's arid regions. These newfound water sources will deliver the ingredient to turn wastelands into thriving centers of agriculture. Water will bring not only life to Moroccan land, but with it the potential for new jobs, financial stability, and food security.
La stratégie énergétique nationale a comme objectif de développer, de créer de l'emploi, d'améliorer les conditions de la population marocaine à travers cet accès généralisé à l'énergie et également à travers de l'emploi. Alors le Maroc importe aujourd'hui plus de 94% de son énergie primaire. Donc le Maroc dépend à plus de 90% d'un approvisionnement extérieur. Dans ce cadre-là, il est très très important de sécuriser l'accès à l'énergie. Le Maroc vise aujourd'hui, à l'horizon de 2020, 14% de capacité installée en hydraulique, 14% de capacité installée en solaire et 14% de capacité installée en éolien.
The kingdom's transition to renewables is already underway. One example of many is the wind farm near Tangier, operated by Morocco's National Office of Electricity. Since 2009, this 140-megawatt farm has been delivering clean power to Moroccans. Among Africa's largest wind farms, it is testament to Morocco's vision of a clean energy future.
Dans les étapes de la réalisation de ce projet, 350 ouvriers ont travaillé, avec des pointes allant jusqu'à 600 ouvriers. La priorité a été donnée à la main-d'œuvre locale. Donc les équipes de la maintenance et des gardiennages et des prestations de nettoyage, les villageois locaux sont favorisés. Le parc est d'une puissance installée de 140 MW. Il contribue presque 2,5% dans la production totale marocaine. À l'horizon 2020, on aura une part de 42% de l'énergie renouvelable.
It's a national concern, what is going to be left for the future generations. It's not a matter of energy ministry alone. And I think when you talk with kids that are tomorrow's leaders, this is something they're very cautious about and very concerned about.
I'm currently performing my internship in order to not only gain my degree, but also to gain a very strong and efficient experience within the work of an R&D private department office. I think that for now, not many people have such opportunity to actually attend even middle school or high school, notwithstanding the fact of accessing university. And I really hope that with all the efforts that the government is putting on renewable energy resources, this issue would be solved. With such natural resources that could be used into renewable energies, I think that we can rely on more than oil This is for me what a mechanical engineering discipline can stand for. Not only just machines, but every mechanism within life.